I am Larry Hetcher. This is Psych 302 Computer Applications and Data Analysis, and we're going to take a look at Jamovi Exercise 090-01, ANOVA with one between subjects factor, input assumptions, and analysis. Exercise overview. This exercise deals with material that appears in the first half of lecture notes, chapter 090, ANOVA with one between subjects factor, specifically from approximately pages 1 to 33 of that set of lecture notes. Our investigation. Screen size and reading enjoyment. Imagine that an electronics corporation has developed a new line of e-readers, electronic tablets similar to the Kindle or the Nook, which can be used to read electronic versions of books and magazines. To determine which e-reader is best liked by potential users, you conducted an investigation with a sample of just 24 college student volunteers. At the beginning of the semester, you randomly assigned each student one of three treatment conditions. One group, with eight people in it, was assigned to spend the semester using an e-reader with a 6-inch screen. One group with a different eight people in it was assigned to spend the semester with an e-reader with a 10-inch screen, and one group with eight people was assigned to spend the semester using an e-reader with a 12-inch screen. Dependent variable in your study was reading enjoyment. This construct was created by asking participants to complete a multiple item summated rating scale consisting of items such as "I love using this e-reader." Scores could range from 1 to 100. Higher scores indicated greater reading enjoyment. Independent variable. The predictive variable in this analysis was screen size. Your research hypothesis was reading enjoyment scores will be higher in the 12-inch screen condition than in the 10-inch or 6-inch conditions, and those in the 10-inch condition will be higher than those in the 6-inch condition. Task 1, performing the analysis in Jamovi. You'll now use Jamovi to perform ANOVA on the preceding dependent variable. In doing this, follow the instructions provided in Lecture Notes, Chapter 090, ANOVA with one between subjects factor. Specifically, you'll do this. Start the Jamovi application in the usual way. If you're using a Windows computer and Jamovi's already installed on it, you'll start Jamovi the same way you start any application. Click the Start icon in the lower left corner of the screen. Scroll down to the J section of the resulting list of programs. Open the Jamovi folder and click Jamovi. This should produce the initial Jamovi interface. If you're instead using a cloud-based version, click the following link. It will take you to Jamovi. Respond to the prompts provided there, and the Jamovi interface will open. Now, this exercise will be different from some of the other exercises you've completed, because with this exercise, you'll create your data set from scratch rather than downloading the data set that's already been created. To create this data set, you'll use the lecture notes for the current unit, that is, Lecture Notes Chapter 090, specifically the section headed Instructions for Creating the Current Dataset from Scratch, which begins somewhere around page 5. Here's the dataset that you will type or paste into your Jamovi spreadsheet. Initial table of raw data for participants in the screen size and reading enjoyment study. We have three columns, one headed participant, one headed screen size, one headed enjoyment. To copy type or copy and paste the values in the preceding table into your empty Jamovi spreadsheet. Specifically, take the values in the column headed participant in the preceding table, either type or paste them into the column of the Jamovi spreadsheet headed A. Take the values in the column headed screen size in the preceding table and type or paste them into the column of the Jamovi data spreadsheet headed B. And take the values in the column headed enjoyment and put them in the column of the Jamovi data spreadsheet headed C. I'm on page 4 of our exercise handout now. In Jamovi, double-click the column heading at the top of the first column, the column initially headed A. to open the data variable panel for this variable. In the data variable panel for this first variable, give it the variable name participant. In the same data variable panel, do the following. In the pull-down menu next to the heading measure type, select ID to indicate that this is merely an identification variable. In the pull-down menu next to the heading data type, select integer so that Jamovi will treat it as an integer variable. And in the data variable panel, click the right pointing arrow so that you'll be moved to the data variable panel for the next column, the column that was initially headed B. In this column that was initially headed B, it codes the treatment condition to which given participant had been assigned under the screen size independent variable. If it contains values 1, 2, and 3, they indicate whether somebody was in the 6-inch condition, the 10-inch condition, or the 12-inch condition. So your next task is to assign meaningful value labels to replace these numbers 1, 2, and 3. In the data variable panel, which was initially headed B, do the following. I will spare you actually reading out loud these instructions, but you will follow the following instructions in order to give meaningful labels to those categories 1, 2, and 3. I continue. I'm still on page 4, toward the bottom of page 4. The column that was initially headed C contains participant scores on the reading enjoyment dependent variable. In the data variable panel for this variable, do the following. And once again, I will spare you the details, but on bottom page 4, beginning at the bottom page 4, it gives you detailed instructions on how to specify the nature of this third variable, scores on the reading enjoyment dependent variable. When finished, I am on page 5 now. When finished, your completed Jamovi spreadsheet should look something like the following. First column is now headed participant, gives a unique participant number to each subject. Next column is headed screen size, and we now have meaningful labels for the three categories. We've identified these folks as being in the 6-inch condition, these folks as being in the 10-inch condition, and so forth. And finally, the third column is now headed enjoyment, and this contains people's scores on the reading enjoyment variable. Once you've created the data set in Jamovi, you'll request statistics and plots similar to those that appeared in the lecture notes section headed requesting descriptive statistics and performing the ANOVA. You will request all plots and all statistics that had been requested in those lecture notes chapter 090. That means all the statistics that I illustrated regarding the descriptive procedure, as well as all the requests that I made using the ANOVA procedure. Do add your name to the top of the Jamovi results panel. I have the usual instructions for doing that here. We continue to page 6. Page 6, preview of some of the correct Jamovi results. If you perform the statistical analysis correctly, results you obtain should match the results provided below, except there'll be a few differences that I mention here. It is always important, once you've done your analysis, take a very close look at the results you obtained, compare it to my hint output, and make sure it matches up. If any of your statistics are different from my statistics, something went wrong. Maybe you keyed an incorrect value in keying up the data set. Maybe you didn't request the right number of decimal places. Hopefully you get started on this exercise early enough that you've got time to consult me in case there are any problems. But the results you get should match these. Your descriptive statistics should look like these descriptive statistics. I have a note that says, yes, the descriptives table that you create will include a lot more statistics than are displayed in this screen capture. This is just a hint. You will request the ANOVA procedure, and your results from the ANOVA procedure should match my results in this ANOVA table. You'll request post-hoc tests, and your post-hoc test should match my post-hoc test. You should request a plot of your estimated marginal means, and it should look very, very similar to mine, with the same labels here and the same labels there. Task 2. I'm at the bottom of page 7 now. Task 2, taking the multiple choice quiz. At the same time I assign this exercise, I will also publish a related multiple choice quiz in Canvas This section provides a study guide that should help you prepare for that quiz. Once you have your results, take a close look at my study guide and make sure that you can answer all the questions that I have here in this study guide. Things like question 6, according to the results presented in the descriptives table, which of the three treatment conditions displayed the greatest degree of skew? In other words, which treatment condition was the most skewed? What was the obtained skewness statistic for this condition? Make sure that you can answer all my questions in this study guide before you take the multiple choice quiz. As always, you don't write up your answers here. You don't submit them to me. I provide this to you just so that you can prepare and be ready before you take that multiple choice quiz. Task 3, you will perform. Task 3 is uploading your Jamovi file in Canvas assignments. In the assignments section of our course in Canvas, you will upload the Jamovi file that you have just created. You've heard me say before, it is usually a good idea to take the multiple choice quiz before you upload it. Sometimes you'll take the multiple choice quiz and discover that none of the answers in the multiple choice quiz match the kind of results that you got in your output. That usually means that you did something wrong in your analysis and you have time to go back and fix your analysis before you upload it. So this has been Jamovi Exercise 09001, ANOVA with one between factor, input, assumptions, and analysis.